Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This is the lecture number 3, Business Ethics and Corporate Social Responsibilities. Before this, we have covered the two case studies. First one on the Merck and Company, a pharmaceutical company. And second one, we worked on manufacturers of vehicles. And the case was where we studied the A7D test plan brakes, and the company made it for Air Force, American Air Force, but there were the two tractors. One was the Lawson and second one was the Kermit, engineer and technical report writers respectively. And we see that how they feel guilty after signing a bad or technical faults based reports. And they save their jobs, but they face and feel guilty during signing their report. After that, we studied the definition of morality. What is morality? In morality, we see the case study, Goodrich Engineers. Then we divided the standards into moral standards and conventional standards or non-moral standards. After that, in this lecture, we are going to discuss four concepts more about the moral and non-moral standards and values. Usually the psychologists said the moral norms and non-moral norms or convention norms can be differentiated at the age of 3. A child can differentiate what is moral and what is conventional, like the theft is moral mistake, and if you are not agree to wear a specific dress, it is a non-moral or a conventional mistake. So at the age of 3 onward, the distinguish ability between moral and non-moral standards are developed among the children, and children can easily differentiate between these two concepts. The philosophers and researchers suggested 6 characteristics that helps to differentiate between the moral and conventional norms or the values or the standards. We are going to here discuss one by one. First one is moral standards deal with matter that are serious. The serious issues are dealt by the moral standards, like theft, like backbiting, like other things which are dangerous to others, that hurts to others. These all kind of norms are deal under the umbrella of moral standards. First one. If you hit a child, if you do rape, theft, murder, all these things are included in the moral standards, and eventually they are converted into the legal standards or legal laws. Second one is the moral standards are based on global vision they are not focusing on the self-interest. When a person is focusing or preferring their or his self-interest on the group interest or the community interest, it means they are violating the moral standards. There are many examples where people do their actions to save their own lives, their own interests, own assets, and sacrifice the others simultaneously. So all these kind of facts are also included in the moral standards. If we are not following the group interest, we are actually violating the moral standard, the high moral standard. Third one is moral standards not established by the authorities or figures or like the senior people, and they cannot change in the standards of morality. So they are made by the society, developed in the society, followed by the society, and overall group accept it, overall society accept it or reject it. For example, if authority said that the theft is not a problem, stealing is not a problem, it doesn't mean that it is not a problem. It is still a problem, but on the extent of that person, that authority, as he or she is considering, that is not a problem, it's not immoral, but the society think that it is a immoral. Fifth one, based on impartial considerations. What are the impartial considerations? When we follow the moral standards, we consider everyone equal and we justify it, we develop the justice in the society, we do everything with everyone with the same standards. If we do some partial consideration, if we do some injustice between the people, between the societies, or between the individuals, then it means it's immoral. Moral point of view said that we should be equal for everyone. Next, the last point regarding the moral standard is associated with special emotions and vocabulary. Moral standards develop special emotions. When we do something good, we feel happiness, we feel relaxed, and when we do something wrong, we feel guilty. It only happens with the moral standard, not with the conventional standards. Like in conventional standards, we have different ceremonial activities during our marriages, like tel, mehndi. If we did not do it, mehndi, it doesn't mean that we feel guilty. But the culture didn't like this, but it doesn't mean you will feel guilty if you do something, if you not do something regarding conventional standards. But regarding the moral standards, if you will do something good, if you will help other people, if you will arrange the justice for all the people, if you will prefer the interest of the society than own self, it means you are maintaining the moral standards, high moral standard, and you will feel special emotions, you will feel happiness, relax, and other people will enjoy as well. So these are the six things which we need to understand regarding the moral standard. What are the properties of the moral standards, characteristics of the moral standards? Here are the six characteristics: involve serious wrong or significant benefits, should be preferred to other values including self-interest, not established by authority figures, are to be universal, based on impartial considerations, associated with special emotions and vocabulary. So you guys can read out these pages and you will understand more detail, and you will enjoy the reading of these characteristics. Now we are going to shift on the next topic. That topic is ethics. What is the ethics, the discipline that examines one's moral standards or the moral standards of a society to evaluate their reasonableness and their implication for one's life. What ethics means? It is a discipline. ये एक बकायदा प्रोग्राम है, एक सिस्टम है जिसके तहत ये देखा जाता है कि कोई सोसाइटी जो है उसके मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स क्या हैं, या उस सोसाइटी, वो जो सोसाइटी है वो किस तरह के मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स बनाती है, इस्तेमाल करती है, फिर उनको एवेल्युएट करना कि वो किस लेवल के मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स हैं, और फिर उन मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स का इफेक्ट देखना उस सोसाइटी के ऊपर. दिस इज कॉल्ड एथिक्स. सुनिए, द डिसिप्लिन दैट एग्जामिन्स वन्स मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स, एक ऐसा तरीकेकार जिसमें मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स को एग्जामिन किया जाए और द मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ सोसाइटी, यानी कि किसी सोसाइटी को एग्जामिन करेंगे तो उसके मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स का आपको पता चलेगा, और उसकी बुनियाद पर फिर आप एवेल्युएट करेंगे कि रीजनेबलनेस एंड देयर इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ वन लाइफ, की ये स्टैंडर्ड जो हैं वो अच्छे हैं, बुरे हैं, कितने अच्छे हैं, किस लेवल के स्टैंडर्ड हैं, और फिर उन स्टैंडर्ड की वजह से आम इंसान की जिंदगी जो है वो कितनी जो है वो चेंज है, कितने लोग सच्चे हैं, कितने लोग कमिटेड हैं, कितने लोग हेल्प करते हैं, कितने लोग जो हैं वो सोसाइटी को प्रेफर करते हैं अपनी ज़ात से पहले, कितने लोग ऐसे हैं जो दूसरों की मदद करते हैं, दे फील हैप्पी. ये सारी चीज़ें जो हैं वो एथिक्स के तहत आती हैं. बेसिकली एथिक्स जो हैं एक ऐसा डिसिप्लिन है जो स्टैंडर्ड्स, किसी भी सोसाइटी के अंदर जो मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स हैं, अखलाकियात के जो मियार हैं, उनको वैल्यूएट करके देखते हैं कि उस सोसाइटी के जो अखलाकी मियार है उसका उन लोगों की ज़िंदगी के ऊपर वाकई तक असर भी है, या जस्ट दे आर मेड द स्टैंडर्ड्स बट दे आर नॉट ट्रूली फॉलोइंग दैम. सो दिस इज द एथिक्स. जैसे कि आपने ग्रीन रिच कंपनी में देखा कि वैंडवियर एंड द लॉसन इंजीनियर्स, दे साइन द रिपोर्ट बट देयर मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड वर मच बेटर देन द अदर पीपल, सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर फीलिंग गिल्टी, ऑल्दो दे आर लिविंग इन द सेम सोसाइटी, बट सम पीपल आर फॉलोइंग द हाई स्टैंडर्ड एंड सम पीपल आर फॉलोइंग द लो स्टैंडर्ड्स. अब नेक्स्ट, एथिक्स इज नॉट ओनली द वे टू स्टडी मोरालिटी. मोरालिटी को, मोरालिटी अगेन मैं आपको रिवाइज कराता चलूं, मोरालिटी मीन्स द स्टैंडर्ड्स, मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स वेयर द पीपल एंजॉय देयर लाइफ, लिव देयर लाइफ्स, सो दैट इज द मोरालिटी. मोरालिटी मीन्स द स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ अ सोसाइटी, मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ अ सोसाइटी, इमोरल स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ अ सोसाइटी, कन्वेंशनल स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ अ सोसाइटी. So the scholar said that this is not the only way to judge the morality of the society. Ethics is not only the way, there are many other ways, there are different studies that helps the people to find the moral standards of the society. First one is a normative study. What is a normative study? An investigation that attempts to reach conclusions about what things are good or bad, or about what actions are right or wrong. Normative study में क्या होता है कि आप एक रिसर्च कंडक्ट करते हैं, एक इन्वेस्टिगेशन करते हैं, एक तफ्तीश करते हैं, जिसमें आप कोशिश करते हैं किसी नतीजे पे पहुंचने की, कि पता चल सके क्या चीज़ जो है वो सही है, क्या चीज़ जो है वो गलत है, क्या रॉन्ग है और क्या राइट है. इसके थ्रू आपको मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स का आइडिया होगा कि मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड जो है वो क्या है. सेकंड वन इज अ डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टडी. डिस्क्रिप्टिव वर्ड निकला है डिस्क्राइब से, सिर्फ बयान कर देना. एन इन्वेस्टिगेशन दैट अटेम्प्ट्स टू डिस्क्राइब और एक्सप्लेन द वर्ल्ड विदाउट रीचिंग एनी कंक्लूजन्स about whether the world is as it should be. डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टडी में आप सिर्फ अपनी तफ्तीश जो है, आपकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन जो है वो एक्सप्लेन कर देते हैं, आप प्रेजेंट कर देते हैं वहां पे, और आप कोई फैसला नहीं देते. जस्ट आप एक ओपन जो है वो डिबेट छोड़ देते हैं और फैसला करने का हक देते हैं पढ़ने वालों को, देखने वालों को, समझने वालों को. तो दैट काइंड ऑफ स्टडी इज कॉल्ड डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टडी. नॉर्मेटिव स्टडी जो है उसके अंदर आप जब इन्वेस्टिगेशन करते हैं तो साथ एक कंक्लूजन भी देते हैं. जैसे कि अगर एक जज है तो जज जब इन्वेस्टिगेशन करेगा और तो उसके साथ एक कंक्लूजन देगा, एक जजमेंट देगा, दैट इज अ नॉर्मेटिव स्टडी. और जब कोई एक पुलिस कहलकर कोई तफ्तीश करता है और तफ्तीश करने के बाद अपनी रिपोर्ट अदालत को सबमिट करता है तो दैट इज अ डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टडी. सेम काइंड ऑफ स्टडीज वी आल्सो डू इन द universities in the research PhD and the MS levels, where we also do the normative studies and descriptive studies as well. It depends on the situation and research questions. So here up to we learn that what is the morality, what is the moral standard, what are the immoral standard or conventional standards, and what is the ethics, what is the normative study, what is the descriptive study. These topics we have covered up till now. Next topic that we are going to start, that is a business ethics. Actually, from here we are going to start business ethics. Before this, we learn just the ethics standards, moral standards, non-moral standards, conventional standards, descriptive studies, morality, like that. But the previous discussed topics will be discussed here again and again in the future topics. So please listen the lectures again and again. Last three lectures you will learn the basic concept. Read the book carefully. Without reading the book you cannot understand the subject, the definition, the concepts. And the next lecture we will discuss the what are the business ethics and what are the role of business ethics in the development of society, development of the individuals, development of the organizations, and to make it a ethical global business world. Thank you.